right, I'm here with Mark Zabel of Matrix. How are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you.
So tell me a little bit about Matrix.
Yeah, so Matrix is our premium commercial brand with a variety of products that serves primarily the commercial segment. Matrix is actually the commercial brand of our parent company, Johnson Health Tech. And Johnson Health Tech has been in business since 1975, producing premium fitness products. And so since 2001, the Matrix brand was established. We have 26 wholly owned subsidiaries worldwide. We distribute products in over 100 countries, and we have about 75 distribution partners worldwide as well.
Wow, that's impressive. So speaking of products, do you have anything new here at IHRSA this year?
Yeah, we actually, this is one of our bigger years in the terms of the number of new products that we've launched. And we've really focused our product launches around our growth strategies. So those include, you know, our core business, adjacent channels such as athletics, and then around us what we call subsegmentation or group training. So you see in a lot of commercial facilities that they're being segmented out in terms of specialized training. So it could be small group training, personal training. So that's one of our growth strategies as well. And finally, a lot of new products around technology. So, you know, if we're focusing around the core business, we've had a redesign of our Ultra series. So 19 newly designed strength training products, which is our premium selectorized single station line. And then one of the reasons that we redesigned our Ultra Series product is so that we could integrate what's called our intelligent training console. And an intelligent training console is integrated on top of the weight stack tower of our Ultra Series. And it works well with what we call our Matrix Connected Solutions. So Matrix Connected Solutions is our integrated digital ecosystem. And so it really works well around for the club owner and the service technician around data collection, but also for mentoring and motivating members in terms of their workouts. So part of that digital ecosystem includes what's called our personal trainer portal. Our personal trainer portal allows facilities to customize, to coach, to train, really for the trainer to engage with that member in a very much more personal and customized way. Our workout tracking network is part of that digital ecosystem. And so people are using multiple mobile applications to track their workout, to motivate them. And so our workout tracking network allows all that data to go where people want to go with their data to these different mobile applications. And finally, the last component of our digital ecosystem is around asset management. And so that's a collection of data so that owners and operators and service technicians can better manage their assets through, hey, what kind of programs are people using? How much usage have I got out of these products? It allows them to rotate products for products that may not be used as much so they can extend life out of that. And then finally, in terms of our hardware, our 7XI console, you know, there's just a growing number of mobile applications that we've integrated onto that console. But it's really focused around motivation, entertainment. I mean, people can stream music, Netflix mobile applications, Hulu, a number of different cool things that really encompasses that whole integrated ecosystem, digital ecosystem. In terms of high-intensity interval training, I talked about adjacent channels, right? And so we've created a new product that's really targeted at, I would call it, at athletic-style training. So we've developed a whole area in our booth called Speed Technique Training. And the name of the product that we launched that is integrated around Speed Technique Training is our S-Force Performance Trainer. I don't believe there's any other product out there that can get as much range of motion or as much muscular engagement as this product. So we designed it around really high intense athletic type performance. But a lot of people that are working out in health club facilities today, they want to train like athletes. So the product really can work well with the mainstream audience as well. So finally, the last component of it, subsegmentation, group training. Number of great new products that we've launched there too, in relation to our MX4 multimodality training concept, really focuses around speed, power, endurance, and cardiovascular conditioning. So we created a new Kinexus Step Plus, super versatile product in terms of not just for step aerobics, but you can do push-ups, dips, core stability training on that. We've developed products with our Conexus line that more compact solutions, perhaps for studios or one-on-one training for larger facilities. And then finally, some more storage. So you see a lot of accessories in commercial facilities laying around on the ground, but we create a really cool storage solution that's more intuitive for the end user. Finally, let's close out on group training, but our Matrix indoor cycles. So we created a booth within the booth around there, so a lot of high energy, lighting, music, but our new indoor cycle, we're featuring what's called our CXP model, and it's really around personalized performance. It has an integrated console that allows people to train with color, but also a variety of different metrics, so five different metrics that people can train to. So we really focused on ergonomics, serviceability, but a lot of motivational training around that group training space, specifically on the indoor cycle. So it's a lot of stuff that we brought to IHRSA this year.
That is a lot of stuff. Wow. So I know you just listed and spoke about all of your products, but what would you say separates Matrix from the competition?
You know, I'm going to start with our people. I mean, we have a lot of people in our organization that have a lot of great experience. We focus a lot on development and continuous improvement. And so our people are fully engaged with their own personal development, but also development around the industry. So I will start with that. Second, you know, the number of products I just mentioned, we believe we have the largest, most comprehensive portfolio in the industry. So when you walk into commercial facilities, what do you see? It's a great deal of variety, and that's what we wanted to make sure our product roadmap and our portfolio resembled, because we believe variety is the key to keep people engaged and keep progressing with their fitness program and their variety of different workouts. You know, innovation is another thing that we really focus on. What sets us apart is what we call stakeholder data gathering. And so we're getting input from personal trainers, service technicians, end users, a lot of observation and end user behavior, but then also owners and operators. And so we're taking that input from them, understanding their challenges, and really challenging the status quo with some different innovation that we're putting into our products.
That's awesome. So with all of this innovation, where do you see the fitness industry in, say, 10 years?
That's a good question. It's hard for me to predict where it will be in 10 years, but you know, I think what you see a lot of, a great deal of what's going on in our industry is a lot of focus around technology. So I think where you see technology today around connectivity and all the solutions that I just talked about, but I think people will be even further engaged. I think people will have a higher expectation around technology. So technology is certainly going to play a huge part in our industry 10 years from now, and it's going to look quite different from where it did today. But you know, at the same time, we're in this high-touch industry, so you can't get away from what people really enjoy doing today. So treadmills are still going to be around, ellipticals, bikes. In fact, I think we saw in IHRSA's report again that the activity participation rates on treadmills is at 44%. It's the highest of any other category. And so I think people still will want to train in a very natural environment, but variety is also going to continue to be a key in the industry 10 years from now.
Great answer. So anybody that hasn't come to IHRSA before that's in this industry, what advice do you have to someone considering exhibiting or attending, just in general, your experience with IHRSA?
Well, you know, IHRSA's got a great staff, so consult with them first and really understand, you know, talk to them about what your needs are and what your goals are as an organization, and I think they can consult with you in terms of, you know, how to develop a plan and what your strategy may be to exhibit at a great show like IHRSA.
All right, Mark. Well, thank you so much, and we'll talk to you soon.
All right, thank you.